नमस्ते ए स्टैंडर्ड. सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन आनंदी बाई आनंदी गोपाल एंड ऑटोबायोग्राफी. सो इन दिस पार्ट वी विल डिस्कस हाउ शी अचीव्ड व्हाट आर हर अचीवमेंट्स एंड हाउ शी बिकेम अ मेडिकल प्रोफेशनल. इन द लास्ट वीडियो we came to know what is autobiography. Autobiography is nothing but the story of a person's life written by person himself, and biography is the person's life written by somebody else. So this is a autobiography of Anandi Gopal. In the last video we have studied, we came to know when Anandi Bai was born. She was born on 31st March 1865 and her name was changed to Anandi. Her previous name was Yamuna Joshi, who was born in Kalyan, which situated in near Mumbai. So they were the family lords, landlords in the town, small town, but the riches have lost. She got married in her 9 year when she was 9 year old. She was married to one Gopal Rao. After her marriage, she started studying. Her husband encouraged her to study. Though he did not get any opportunity to make her study, he utilized all the opportunity he got. In the beginning, her husband had already tried to enroll her in the missionary schools, but it did not work out. And then when they moved from Kalyan to Alibag and from Alibag to Kolhapur, and finally they settled in Calcutta. So there she started studying, and she progressed rapidly. And her husband insisted her to join higher education. So she planned to join any medical course, because the situation in those days was totally different. In those days there were very less female doctors. That's why Anandi Bai thought. So, as women were hesitant to approach any male doctor, it is better if she became female. If she become a doctor, she can solve many problems faced by women. Then we also came to know how she went to abroad. She tried to get admission in university in America. And there her husband corresponded to one carpenter of Rosale in New Jersey. So because she came to know, carpenter of Rosale came to know the difficulty faced by Anandi Bai, she decided to call her there and as a correspondent to her. And she offered to host her in the USA. So since Gopal Rao wasn't able to get a new job there, and they thought that it is better to go alone, Anandi Bai thought of going alone to America. So they faced a very big problem, like they got criticism from the people, local people, and oppositions from the local people and society. The people had thrown stones and cow dungs on them. But finally, after facing these obstacles, she reached America and met a carpenter whom she called as Mawasi, that is aunt. So she reached America. Now from fifth para. In America, there were many things that I thought were strange and many that the carpenters found strange in me. For example, the carpenters found it odd that I wouldn't sit down on a chair when Mr. Carpenter was in the room, as was the custom in India then, and I was astonished that they didn't bathe every day. Other things like my clothes and my not eating non-vegetarian food was also very strange for them. Carpenter Mawashi took care of me as if I were her own daughter. She cried like a child when she left me at the women's college in Philadelphia. So here we can see how when after reaching America, Carpenter Mawashi had received her, and there was so many difference of custom there. Carpenters found it is odd. She never used to sit when Mr. Carpenter was there in the room, as it was a custom in the Indian societies that whenever male members of the family, when they are there in the sitting room or anywhere, the women folk will not sit there as a respect to the male folk. And the other things like her clothes and her not eating non-vegetarian food, these all things were found strange. And what she found strange about the carpenters was they did not take bath every day. So, and one more thing was they were non-vegetarian. They used to take continuously non-vegetarian food. So these things are the differences of their custom and culture and Miss Anandi Bai's custom and culture. Ultimately, she got admission in a college, women's college in Philadelphia. Para number 6. The superintendent and the secretary of the college were very kind. They were impressed that I had come to study from far away, braving poverty and opposition from my people. They even offered me a scholarship of $600 for the 3 years. So after getting admission in the women's college in Philadelphia, she found the superintendent and the secretary of the college very kind towards Anandi Bai, and they got very impressed by her as she came to Philadelphia from far away places, braving the poverty and all the opposition, facing all the opposition from the people. That's why they offered her a scholarship of $600 for 3 years. Coming to para number 7. The room that was provided to me at the college didn't have a proper fireplace. The fireplace emitted a lot of smoke when it lit. So it was a choice between smoke and cold. I tried to get another place, but that was not possible, as no one was ready to rent a place to a brown Hindu girl trying to be a doctor. After about 2 years in that place, I had started having a constant temperature and cough. Well, living in an alien culture, weather was always going to be difficult, and I was ready to face it. So in that room, this is a description of the room where she used to stay. So that room was the room provided to her from the college. It didn't have proper fireplace, and next it emitted lot of smoke when it was lit. So why there used to be fireplace? The place, the weather is very cold there. They have to lit fire so that they can increase the temperature of the room. But the room provided to Anandi Bai was not, it did not have any chimney type. It was not proper. The smoke didn't go out of the room. So soon she got cold and cough. And she tried to arrange for another room, but she could not arrange another room as she was in an alien place. And in that place, a Hindu a brown Hindu girl who had come there to become a doctor was considered, they were not ready to give her any place or room. Now coming to, Anandi Bhai had decided that one way or other, she will tolerate all the difficult situation and she will face every situation and she will become a doctor. Para number 8. My health was severely affected by my stay there. After around 2 years in the USA, I had sudden spells when I used to feel very faint and get a high temperature. The cough fever left me. By the end of the 3 years, my condition had worsened. I somehow scraped through the final exam. At the convocation where my husband was present, I was announced that I was the first woman doctor of India and a standing ovation for that. It was one of the most rewarding moments of my life. Day by day, I grew worse and nothing worked. My husband then admitted me to the Women's Hospital in Philadelphia. I was then diagnosed as having tuberculosis, but the disease hadn't yet reached my lungs. The doctors advised me to go back to India. So she somehow could finish her studies. After 3 years, she got her degree, doctor's degree. At the convocation where the husband was present, it was announced that she was the first woman to get a doctor's degree. And she got a standing ovation by the public who have assembled there. But her health condition got worsened. And she was admitted to a women's hospital in Philadelphia. And there she was found, she was diagnosed that she has tuberculosis. The tuberculosis means it is a disease of lungs where you must have heard about TB. Tuberculosis, but the disease hadn't reached her lungs. So the disease was not that severe at that time, and the doctor said it is better to go to India for the further treatment. So till here you study para number 5, 6, 7, 8. So till here you study hard and try to answer the questions behind your textbook. So I will continue the same lesson from para number 9 and 10 and also the questions and answers in my next video. Till then, take care. Namaste.